Hi everyone, Namaste. I hope all are doing well. So in the last class, we completed the chemical properties of 16th group element. So in chemical properties, mostly three reactions we completed. One is the reaction with hydrogen, another one is the reaction with oxygen, and the third one is the reaction with halogen. So total three properties we completed. So in the reaction with halogens, we completed that halogens combines with 16th group elements, formation of tetrahalides, hexahalides, also some dihalides also possible. In hexahalides, mostly fluorides will form because of big size of chlorine and bromine. It is not possible. So mostly in hexahalides, fluorides will exist. In tetrahalides, all are possible, and dihalides also all are possible. However, oxygen does not form dihalides. Remember that oxygen does not form dihalides. That means not chlorides are remaining. Oxygen mostly combines with fluorine. They form two halides. That is OF2 and O2F2. So these two are most important. Oxygen, fluorine, whenever they are combining, one is form OF2, another one will form O2F2. So, in this, both oxygen will show positive charge. When our oxygen combining with other halogen, oxygen will form negative charge. But when oxygen combining with chlorine, oxygen will form positive charge. So, that's why these are called fluorides. When oxygen combining with other, all are called oxides. But here, oxygen when combines with chlorine, these are called fluorides. OF2 and O2F2, both are fluorides. Here, oxygen charge will be positive. In OF2, oxygen will show +2. In O2F2, oxygen will show +1. So this structure is similar to hydrogen peroxide. There is a peroxide linkage like this. So this is O2F2 structure. Now, so they also forms monohalides. 16th group elements also form monohalides. But that monohalides mostly exist in dimeric form. They already been completed, and these exist in dimeric form like S2F2, S2Cl2, SeA2F2, SeA2Cl2. We already completed that the dimeric monohalides undergo disproportionation reaction like SeA2Cl2. Will undergo disproportionation reaction. Produce SeCl4 and 3Se. So most of these dimeric monohalides structure is similar to hydrogen peroxide. So any monohalide structure when you are observing SSF2 or sorry here Cl2 suppose. What am I writing? Sorry. S2F2, S2Cl2, SeA2F2, SeA2Cl2. So same like we are taking SeCl. So all these structures, dimeric monohalide structures are similar to hydrogen peroxide structure. There is always central atom linkage will be there. So this is about halides. Now along with oxides, halides and hydrides, they also form oxyhalides. 16th group also forms oxyhalides. So what oxyhalides are? So oxyhalides containing both oxygen atom and also halogen atom. So mostly sulfur and selenium will form oxyhalide. Sulfur oxyhalides also called thionyl halide, whereas selenium called selenyl halide. So both thionyl halides and selenyl halides, both are oxyhalides. Oxyhalide means along with halogen, oxygen atom is also present. So those are called oxyhalides. So sulfur will form thionyl halide, selenium will form selenyl halide. Example, SOF2 and SOCl2. So thionyl chloride. Same like SeOF2, SeOCl2. selenide hydrides, selenide chloride and selenide chloride, sulfonyl, thionyl chloride and thionyl chloride. This thionyl chloride we have seen in the organic chemistry reactions. Thionyl chloride. So, oxygen halides means along with oxygen, halogen atom also present. Those are called oxygen halides. So, oxygen halides are mostly formed by sulfur and selenium. So, sulfur oxygen halides are called thionyl halides. Selenium oxygen halides are called selenyl halides. So, these are examples of oxygen halides. And sulfur also form another important compound SO2Cl2. So, this is called sulfuryl chloride. So, SOCl2 thionyl chloride, SO2Cl2 sulfuryl chloride. When two oxygens are present, that is called sulfuryl chloride. So, these two will come in organic chemistry. In the preparation of haloalkane chapter, we use SOCl2 thionyl chloride. Similarly, in the carbonyl compounds reactions, SO2Cl2 will come sulfuryl chloride. So, thionyl chloride and sulfuryl chloride. So, both are oxyhalides. Along with oxygen, halogen atom is present. Those are called oxyhalides. So, this is about chemical properties. Now, so three properties completed: reaction with hydrogen, halogen, and oxygen. The next topic is allotropes. We all know that allotropes are when same element is existing in different physical forms. The topic is called allotropes. The 16th group elements, mostly all elements will form allotropes. For example, oxygen exists in the O2 molecule also, ozone also. So both are oxygen and dioxygen and ozone. Both are allotropes. Similarly, in sulfur, the number of allotropes are possible. Here we study allotropes of sulfur. So sulfur exists in allotropic forms like orthorhombic sulfur, which is also called alpha sulfur. Another one is monoclinic sulfur, also called beta sulfur. Another is also called X1. Plastic sulfur are also called amorphous or delta sulfur. So three important allotropes mostly: orthorhombic, monoclinic, plastic. So orthorhombic is also called alpha, monoclinic is also called beta, plastic is also called delta, which is also called amorphous sulfurs. So mostly in NCERT syllabus we study orthorhombic and monoclinic. So sulfur allotropic forms: orthorhombic, monoclinic and plastic sulfur. So whatever it may be, orthorhombic or it may be monoclinic, sulfur exists in S8. So atomicity of sulfur will be 8. So either orthorhombic or monoclinic will be exist in S8 form. So the structure of S8 should be similar to crown shape. When sulfur atoms are linked and form a crown shape, total 8 sulfur atoms will form crown shape. So this is either orthorhombic sulfur or monoclinic. Both are same shape. So both orthorhombic and monoclinic exist in S8 form. If this on heating, it is break down to S6. So the S6 sulfur shape is similar to chair form. Sulfur. So at high temperature, S8 can be break down to S6. It is chair form. Similarly, if the temperature is near the 1000 Kelvin at very high temperature, near the 1000 Kelvin temperature, it is break down to S2. So S2 means that is a linear molecule, same like oxygen. So normally both orthorhombic or monoclinic will exist in the form of SH. On heating it can break down to S6. S6 is a chain form, S8 is the crown shape. So this is a crown shape and this is a chain form. On high temperature, nearly 1000 Kelvin temperature, it break down to S2 molecule. And this S2 molecule, most important, it is the paramagnetic in nature. The molecule of S2 is paramagnetic in nature. The reason is due to presence of unpaired electrons in the pi star orbitals. That is the main reason why S2 molecule is paramagnetic. S2 molecule is paramagnetic, similar to O2. So we know the electronic configuration of O2 molecule in the molecular orbital theory. In molecular orbital theory, when we are writing the configuration, the O2 molecule, even though electrons are even number, but the presence of unpaired electrons in the pi star orbital will be possible. That's why O2 is paramagnetic. Same like H2 molecule is also paramagnetic due to presence of unpaired electron in the pi star orbital. So H2 is paramagnetic due to presence of unpaired in pi star orbital. So both orthorhombic and monoclinic will be exist in the form of SH. When we are comparing orthorhombic and monoclinic, so orthorhombic monoclinic can be interconvert at a temperature of 369 Kelvin. So at a temperature of 369 Kelvin, both can be interconvert. Below 369, orthorhombic will be exist. Above 369, monoclinic will be exist. Exactly at this temperature, both forms will exist in equilibrium. That's why this temperature is called transition temperature. So 369 Kelvin is the transition temperature for allotropes of the sulfur, orthorhombic sulfur. Remember, orthorhombic sulfur is always most stable than the monoclinic sulfur, and it is high density or high specific gravity means density, most stable and high density but low melting point. So compare these properties, which is more stable means orthorhombic is more stable at room temperature, because below 369 Kelvin orthorhombic will exist, and orthorhombic is highly dense when compared with monoclinic, and it exhibit low melting point, monoclinic is high melting point. So these three properties are important properties of allotropes of sulfur, orthorhombic and monoclinic. So these are about allotropes of sulfur, mostly two important allotropes, orthorhombic and monoclinic. Third is also there, that is also called amorphous sulfur or delta sulfur. So orthorhombic, monoclinic are most important. Both will exist in S8 form. S8 shape is similar to crown shape. On heating, converted to S6, that is a chain form. On heating at high temperature, nearly 1000 Kelvin, it will form S2 molecule. The S2 molecule is paramagnetic in nature due to presence of unpaired electrons in the pi star orbital. So this is about allotropes of sulfur. Now another most important topic in this 16th group, not only 16th group, so this topic is applicable to 17th group also, even 15th group also, that is oxoacids of sulfur, also called oxyacids or oxoacids of sulfur. So in the 15th group, you study oxoacids of phosphorus, Same like in this exchange room, we study oxoacids of sulfur. So what is about first of all, oxoacid means any acid which contains at least one OH group. Any acid which contains at least one OH group, and that acid is called oxoacid. For example, we are taking HCl, hydrochloric acid. It is an acid. So this is an acid, but we cannot call it is an oxoacid. Another one is H2SO4. Sulfuric acid is an acid, but this we can call oxoacid. Both are acids, but one is oxoacid, one is non-oxoacid. So what is oxoacid means? Any acid which contains at least one OH group. So that means it must containing oxygen atom. Then those are called oxoacid. Any one OH group is present, then that acid is called oxoacid. So we are studying oxoacids of sulfur. So sulfur forms mainly two types of oxoacids. One is called sulfurous acid. Another one is sulfuric acid. One is sulfurous. Another one is sulfuric. Sulfurous acid formula H2SO3. It is prepared by reaction of sulfur dioxide with water. Sulfur dioxide with water will form H2SO3. That is called sulfurous acid. Same like sulfuric. Sulfur trioxide when combines with water will form H2SO4. So it is an oxoacid of sulfur trioxide. It is oxoacid of sulfur dioxide. One is sulfurous. Another one is sulfuric acid. So here, in oxoacids, mostly the questions will ask about the structure. How many OH bonds are there? What is the oxidation state? Mostly they will ask. So when we are observing, this sulfurous acid is formed by sulfur dioxide. In sulfur dioxide, charge will be the +4. That's why here also charge will be +4. It is formed by +6. Hence, it is also charge will be +6. Remember that. When oxidation state is higher, acidic character is also higher. This is also acid, this is also acid. But sulfuric acid is stronger than sulfurous since it contains more oxidation state. Acidic character is directly proportional to oxidation state. More the oxidation state, more the acidic character. That's why sulfuric is strong, sulfurous is weak. Now we are writing the structures. Whenever we are writing the structures of oxoacids, remember, first we have to write the central atom. Here, the central atom is sulfur. So, how to identify central atom? So that is the sulfurous acid. Acid of sulfur. Sulfur must be the central atom. Here, three options are there. First, we write central atom. Along with this central atom, we must write one double bond oxygen. Any oxoacids we are writing, first we write double bond oxygen with the central atom. Remaining oxygen must be written in OH form. First, one must be in double bond form. Remaining oxygen must be in OH form. Here we are writing one double bond oxygen. There are remaining two oxygens are there. So we can write two OH groups. This is OH. This is OH. So that is the structure of sulfurous acid. There is a one lone pair is also present because sulfur valence electrons are 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. One lone pair is present. So this is the structure of sulfurous acid. In this sulfurous acid, this is OH group, this is OH group. Here hydrogen bond can break from oxygen. That's why it is called oxoacid. In oxoacids, hydrogen will must come from the oxygen. That's why that is called oxoacid. Here two OH groups are there. That's why this we can write as dibasic acid. Acids always contains basicity. How many OH groups are there? That is called basicity. Here it is an acid, but it contains two OH group. That's why it is called dibasic acid. So all sulfur acids are mostly dibasic acid. Either it may be sulfurous or it may be sulfuric. All are dibasic acid. So this is the structure of sulfurous. So you can write the structure of sulfuric. Same topic, same model. So first we have to write the central atom. The central atom will be sulfur. and we must write one double bond oxygen. So total four oxygens are there. We are writing one double bond oxygen. Remaining three oxygens are there. Remember, remaining oxygens must be written in the form of OH group. So three oxygens are there, but hydrogens are only two. So that means we can write only two OH groups. One OH group this side I am writing. One OH group this side I am writing. So extra one oxygen is remaining. So when the oxygen is remaining, oxygen must be written in double bond form. Single oxygen is double bond form, but OH group in single bond form. Why? Because oxygen valence is always two. Here one oxygen must contain in two bonds. In OH already it contains one bond. That's why it must be a single bond. So this is the structure of sulfuric acid. Sulfuric, sulfurous. This is also two OH groups are there. This will be dibasic acid. So sometimes they will ask oxidation number. Already I told sulfur dioxide. From sulfur dioxide, sulfurous is coming. Oxidation number before. From sulfur trioxide, sulfuric acid is coming. Oxidation number will be 6. Or directly by washing structure, you can write oxidation number. How to it? Here, see this sulfur atom is attached to oxygen atom, oxygen atom, oxygen, oxygen. So it have total 4 bonds with oxygen atoms. Oxygen atom has 4 bonds with sulfur. So that means when sulfur is combining with oxygen, oxygen is more electronegative, sulfur is less electronegative. I told in the last class, whenever two atoms are combining, more electronegative will be negative charge, less electronegative will be positive charge. So when sulfur oxygens are bonding, sulfur will show positive charge, oxygen will show negative charge. The sulfur is total 4 bonds with oxygen, that's why it will show plus 4. Here see, observe, sulfur has total 6 bonds with oxygen, that's why oxidation number will be plus 6. Sulfuric plus 6, sulfurous plus 4. These are oxo acids of sulfur, sulfurous and sulfuric. So other oxo acids also will say. So these structures are most important. In people of events, mostly oxo acid question is compulsory. Either from 15th group, 16th group or 17th group. So another oxo acid, suppose pyrosulfuric acid, which is also called disulfuric acid, or also called oleum. So pyrosulfuric acid, disulfuric acid, or oleum. So what is meant by pyro means? Pyro means losing of water from two molecules. Whenever two molecules combine together and loses water, the process is called pyro. Pyro means removal of water from two molecules. So di means two molecules. So from two molecules and losing water, that is called pyro. So pyro of sulfuric acid. You know the formula of sulfuric? H2SO4. So H2SO4 is sulfuric. But pyro means from two molecules. We are taking two molecules. From these two molecules, we are removing water. Removing of water is called pyro from two molecules. From this, we are removing water. So what are the remaining formulas? It is here total 2 into 2. 4 hydrogens are there. 2 hydrogens are gone. Remaining 2 hydrogens. Similarly, here 2 sulfur atoms are there. 1 sulfuric, 1 sulfur. 2 sulfuric acids, 2 sulfur. Sulfur atom is not losing. That's why total 2 sulfurs are there. Here oxygens are 8. 2 into 4 will be 8. From this 8 oxygen, only 1 oxygen is removing. That's why remaining will be 7. So this is called pyrosulfuric acid. Pyrosulfuric acid formula H2SO7. So we can write this structure. As I told, whenever writing oxo acid structures, first we write central atom. So the central atom is sulfur, but there are two sulfur atoms. So I am writing two sulfur atoms. We don't know between linkage is there or not. First we are writing central atom. After that, the second step, we have to write double bond oxygen on the central atom. Here I am writing double bond oxygen. Here I am writing double bond oxygen. So the next step, whatever the remaining oxygens are there, we have to write in the form of OH2. Here two oxygens we completed, five are there, but hydrogens are only two. That means only two OH groups are there. So this side I am writing one OH group. This side I am writing one OH group. So total four oxygens completed. Remaining again three oxygens are there. And three oxygens are there. Only oxygens, hydrogens are not there. So oxygen valency must be two. It should be written in double bond form. I am writing one here. I am writing another here. So again one oxygen atom is there. So that oxygen atom must be definitely in between these two sulfur atoms to combine it. So we are writing sulfur atom here. So this is the structure of pyrosulfuric acid. So pyro means simply I told, from two molecules when you are removing water, that is called pyro. So without writing the structure, we are writing the structure of sulfuric acid. From the two sulfuric acids we can remove water. So see this. Here again sulfur is attached to 6 bonds, oxidation state of sulfur will be plus 6, here also plus 6. So in pyrosulfuric acid, oxidation state will be plus 6 for each sulfur atom. So this is the structure of pyrosulfuric. Here also 2 OH groups are there, it is called dibasic acid. So the structure also I told, it can be written by removing water from these two molecules. Suppose take this, I am writing structure of sulfuric. This is the sulfuric acid structure, another sulfuric acid. There are two sulfuric acid, from these two molecules if you are removing water, then that is called pyrosulfuric acid. Water means H2O, suppose we are removing. So this is the H2O. On removing H2O, single oxygen will be present between two sulfur atoms. So that is pyrosulfuric acid. So on removing this, so this oxygen linkage will be take place. So this is the pyrosulfuric acid. So pyro means removal of water from two molecules. Remember it. So another number of oxo acids are there. One by one we will see. So we completed sulfurous, sulfuric, pyrosulfuric. Another one is peroxo monosulfuric acid, which is also called carous acid. Peroxo monosulfuric acid, which is also called carous acid. Remember it, peroxo. So peroxo is nothing but peroxy or peroxide. We know that peroxide, hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. So water contains an extra oxygen, that is called peroxide. So peroxy means extra oxygen. Remember, so peroxo means extra oxygen. So whenever extra oxygen is present, that is called peroxo. So peroxo monosulfuric acid. In one sulfuric acid, one extra oxygen is present, and that is called peroxo monosulfuric acid, also called carous acid. You know the formula of sulfuric acid? H2SO4 is the sulfuric acid. If it has one extra oxygen, so this will be H2SO5, that is called peroxo monosulfuric acid. So pyro means removal of water from two molecules. Peroxo means extra oxygen. Remember it. So we are writing the structure as usual. Central atom is sulfur. So there must be double bond oxygen and remaining must be in the form of OH. But here only two hydrogens are there. That means only two OHs are possible. How many extra oxygens are there? Again two oxygens are there. Suppose one we are writing in double bond. Again one extra oxygen is there. And remember that whenever peroxo is coming, peroxo means the extra oxygen must be attached to oxygen. OO linkage is called peroxy linkage. oxygen oxygen must be in single bond, and that linkage is called peroxide linkage. So extra oxygens we cannot add here because already valence is balanced. Now this OH group we are writing as OOH. Now this linkage, oxygen oxygen single bond linkage, is called peroxide linkage. So peroxo means there must be extra oxygen which must be attached to oxygen with single bond. Oxygen oxygen single bond linkage is called peroxide linkage. Remember it. When you are writing the structure of H2O2, hydrogen peroxide, okay, oxygen oxygen linkage is there. That's why it is called peroxide, peroxide linkage. The same like we are writing OOH. Only one extra oxygen. That's why one side I am writing OOH. So this is the structure of peroxo monosulfuric acid, also called carox acid. So we can calculate oxidation numbers. It will be plus 6 because 6 bonds are there with oxygen. Another one is peroxo disulfuric acid, also called Marshall's acid. Peroxo disulfuric, also called Marshall's acid. This is also peroxo. This is also peroxo. But here I am clearly written peroxo monosulfuric. Monosulfuric means for one molecule when we are adding oxygen, that is called peroxo monosulfuric. But here peroxo disulfuric acid. So what is disulfuric acid? I already told before, disulfuric acid is nothing but pyrosulfuric acid, also called oleum. So the formula of oleum is H2S2O7. That is the disulfuric acid formula. Peroxo means addition of oxygen. So it can be converted to H2S2OH. So this is the peroxo disulfuric acid, also called Marshall's acid. So you can write structure. Two sulfurs are there. SS, double bond oxygen. Double bond oxygen. Only two hydrogens are there. So only there are possibility of 2OH group. Now extra 4 oxygens are there. I am writing double bond oxygen here, double bond oxygen here. Again 2 oxygens are there. So these 2 oxygens must be written in OO linkage. So it is the peroxo disulfuric acid. Here we are not writing OOH because here 2 sulfur atoms are there. If one extra OOH we are writing, that will be not possible. Here there is only one central atom. Any side we can write OH. But here 2 central atoms are there. We cannot write OH here or we cannot write OH here. That's why I am writing O bond in central atom. Simply for pyrosulfuric acid, in center one oxygen atom is there. On that extra oxygen is adding. That will come peroxo disulfuric acid. So here each sulfur will exhibit plus 6 oxidation number. So oxo acid structures, oxidation numbers most important. So in this question, what the question will ask mostly? Which acid has OO linkage? Which acid has SS linkage? So this type of question is most important. So peroxo monosulfuric, peroxo disulfuric. Similarly, another two acids are there. One is the thiosulfurous acid. Thiosulfurous acid. So we know the sulfurous acid. What is the formula of sulfurous acid? H2SO3. That is the sulfurous. So thio means sulfur. When oxygen atom is replaced by sulfur, that is called thio. So thio means oxygen is replaced by sulfur. So thio is the chemical name of sulfur. So in place of one oxygen, we are writing sulfur atom, and that is called thiosulfurous. So sulfur atom is replaced by oxygen atom, H2S2O2. That is the structure of, formula of thiosulfuric acid. So you can write this structure. There are two sulfurs are there. First central atom S. Since it is a thio, oxygen is replaced by sulfur. Double bond, not oxygen, double bond sulfur. Remember it, thio sulfurous means when oxygen is replaced by sulfur. So double bond oxygen we have replaced with double bond sulfur. Remaining as usual, OH forms we have to write. There are two oxygens and two hydrogens. That means two OHs are possible. So this is the structure of thiosulfurous acid. So we can identify the oxidation state. Here the central atom is attached to two bonds with oxygen and two bonds with sulfur. And atoms are same, charge will be zero. So that's why with sulfur atom does not exhibit any oxidation state. But with oxygen atom they will show oxidation state. So two bonds are there, that's why sulfur will exhibit plus two, and this sulfur will exhibit oxidation state zero. The last is sulfur atom. This will be plus two, this will be zero. So this is the thiosulfurous. Same like thiosulfuric acid. Thiosulfuric acid. So you can write the formula. Sulfuric acid. What is the formula of sulfuric acid? H2SO4. But thio means what I told? Oxygen atom is replaced by sulfur. So here oxygen will be 3, sulfur will be 2. So one oxygen is replaced by sulfur atom, that is called thiosulfuric. So you can write this structure. In sulfuric acid, as double bond O is possible, but here sulfur is replaced with oxygen, so we are writing S double bond S. 3 oxygens and 2 hydrogen, only 2 OHs are possible. 1 OH, 2nd OH. Another extra oxygen is present, the oxygen must be in double bond form. So that is the structure of thiosulfuric acid. Thiosulfurous, thiosulfuric. So what is the oxidation state here? This sulfur atom does not exhibit any charge. Here total 4 oxygen atoms are there. So this sulfur will show plus 4 and this sulfur will show 0 oxidation state. So another absorbed acid of sulfur will be dithionous acid. Dithionous acid. So here its formula will be H2S2O4. So these two formulas you have to remember. Dithionous acid formula is H2S2O4. So try this structure. Dithionous acid structure. There are central atoms, two central atoms, sulfur, sulfur. So it must be double bond with oxygen. It must be double bond with oxygen. Again, there are two oxygen atoms, two hydrogen atoms, OH, OH. So all are completed. Two sulfur atoms, four oxygen atoms, two hydrogen atoms. So these two must be linked. There is a sulfur sulfur linkage in dithionous acid. So this is the dithionous acid. Same like dithionic acid is there. Its formula is H2S2O6. H2S2O6. So you can write this structure. Sulfur, sulfur. One double bond oxygen, double bond oxygen. And there are two hydrogens, four oxygens are there. So we can write only two OH group. Again, two oxygen atoms are there. Here, this will be double bond oxygen, this will be double bond oxygen. There is a linkage between S and S. So dithionous and dithionic. So both are having SS linkage. In H2S2O4, in H2S2O6, there is a S bond S linkage. One is the thionous, one is the thionic. Similarly, the last one is another important one, tetrathionic acid. Tetrathionic acid. So its formula will be H2S4O6. Already told, thio means sulfur. So dithio means two sulfur atoms. Dithio means two sulfur atoms. tetrathiol means four sulfur atoms are there. So H2S4O6 is the formula of tetrathionous thionic acid. So you can write this structure. Now there are four sulfur atoms: sulfur, 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 sulfur. So we must write double bond oxygen here, here, and there are two hydrogens. This will be OH. This will be OH. Remaining two oxygens will be end actually. So structure is little different. This one double bond oxygen, and this will be linkage. So this is the structure of H2S4O6. So these structures you have to remember: dithionous, dithionic, tetrathionic acids. So oxidation state you can identify here 1, 2, 3 oxygen bonds. One is the sulfur linkage. There is no oxidation state in sulfur linkage. It will exhibit +3 in each sulfur. Here each sulfur will exhibit +5. Here this one exhibit +5. This one will exhibit 0. This one will exhibit 0, and this one will exhibit +5. So oxidation states are also most important. So they will give 2 or 3 molecules. You can write the order of oxidation state. So this is about completely oxo acids of sulfur. So sulfur exhibit number of oxo acids, mostly sulfurous, sulfuric. So sulfuric can be converted to pyrosulfuric by removing water, and also by adding oxygen we can convert it to para-oxo monosulfuric, para-oxo disulfuric. Thiosulfurous, thiosulfuric means if oxygen is replaced with sulfur, that is called thiosulfurous, thiosulfuric. But dithio, dithionic and tetrathionic, these three are little bit different. So you have to practice this structure. So these structures are most important.